song.
You may be seated if you like. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. When I had the honor to receive a phone call from these two to be the one to minister their wedding, I was very honored and shocked at the same time. Just a little story of how this whole thing happened. One day, Rob decides to text me and tells me, "Do you know Shelly?" I told him, "I have no idea who you're talking about." She's like, he's like, "Are you serious?" I'm like, "Yes." He sends me a picture. It's pretty creepy. And I said, "Oh, you mean Missy?" He goes, "Yes, what can you tell me about her?" I said, "Well, you break her heart, I'll break your legs."
You did.
Didn't I?
Yeah.
But I told him, she's a good girl. She's a loving girl. She's a family girl. Just treat her as you would like to be treated yourself. So at this moment, as they told me how to say it in a Spanish accent, right? Roberto y Michelle are going to exchange words to one another. Michelle, you go first.
Oh, no. I apologize ahead of time. Okay. To my husband. All right, I'm crying. Today I stand before you as a woman of God. When I faced obstacles that were supposed to break me, I stood in faith, I gave thanks, because I knew that God's plan was greater than anything I could have ever imagined. I envisioned a fairy tale for so long that I thought wouldn't exist for me. And God, once again, proved me wrong, because here we are, living the fairy tale that was created just for us. I prayed for this. I prayed for a partnership. I prayed for someone who would love, support, and encourage me. I prayed for someone who valued me as a woman, as their woman. I prayed for someone who would protect me. I prayed for someone who would look at me just the way you do. I prayed for you. I promised to laugh with you, cry with you, and grow with you. I promised to support you, respect you, and stand by your side through all the days and nights of our lives. I promise you my unconditional love, my fullest devotion, and my most tender care. My love, you are a breathtaking reflection of God's heart for me. I thank him every single day for choosing us for one another. I love you.
Love you too. That was pretty long. I'm gonna follow that?
A book.
All right. When writing my vows, I had no idea where to begin. You knew that. So I began with the word vow. A vow is a promise, and a vow should always be personal. So to make my vows personal, I use my favorite quote from my favorite book and my favorite movie.
Jurassic Park.
Anyone who knows me knows that's my favorite franchise. In the movie and the book, my favorite character, Ian Malcolm, explains that no matter what happens, life finds a way. And he was right. For years, we had mutual friends, lived so near each other, took the same train to and from the fellows, and yet never crossed paths and never knew each other. Life finds a way, because you came into my life when I needed you most. In my vow, I need to make a promise to someone who saved me from a very dark place, a promise to someone who saw me at my worst and still wanted me. A promise to someone who saw so much potential in me when I didn't see it in myself. A promise to someone who picked me up when I felt alone. As we continue to grow and build our lives together, I promise to love you every day, give you foot massages when you ask. I promise to take care of you and our future family at all costs and be the husband anyone can ask for. I love you, Shelly.
I need one right now.
She says she needs one right now. At this moment, we're going to be doing the ring exchange.
You can
just take one for that.
One?
All right.
It's happening.
Time to run still.
That'll beat me up on the way.
Roberto, you go first. I, Roberto. Take you, Michelle.
You, Michelle.
As my lover forever.
As my lover forever.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or poor.
For richer or poor.
Until my heart gives its last beat.
Until my heart gives its last beat.
Ready. I, Michelle. Take you, Roberto. As my lover forever.
As my lover forever.
To take care of you.
To take care of you.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or poor.
For richer or for poor.
Until my heart gives its last beat.
Until my heart gives its last beat.
Let us bow our heads and pray. Dear Father, we thank you and we acknowledge you at this day, in this moment, for these two that have become one. I thank you for their lives and I thank you for their journey that you are about to embark with them, and that you be the center always and that love be the center as well. We thank you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. At this moment, we're going to ask Angela and David to please come up. They are going to be signing the papers as witnesses in front of you all and God as well.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wait, you need a little.
Where am I signing? No, I got it.
Where am I signing?
Oh, here. No.
Who's the
first? Witness here. Okay.
I'm putting this on my resume. I ask you all to please stand.
Okay. That's it?
Shelly, I give you a word of advice today in front of everyone. I would like to let you know that Rob always has the last word.
Nah.
And it's whatever you say, Shelly. But a word of advice to you guys in front of all your friends and family. 1 Corinthians 16:14 states, do everything in love. At this moment, as the honor and the privilege that the Lord has given me in the state of New York, I pronounce you husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Perez.
Are over.